Got the session. Will you announce once like what we are going to do today?
Yeah, Mataji. So today we are going to speak on subject of anger management. Most of you might not be having that, but I definitely have some. So just trying to purify myself. And really, I'm not qualified enough, but seeking your blessings from all the Vaishnavs and all the Vaishnavis here in this, so I could speak something which is appropriate and useful and meaningful. But before I start, let's start with invocation prayer. Om Ajnana Timrandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gaurivani Pacharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschata Deshatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shivasadi Gaur Bhakta Brinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Gurudev ki jai. So, as I was saying, we are going to speak today on anger management. And we'll try to focus on what is this really source of anger. Why do we have anger? And what can be the possible solutions to manage this anger? And if we see anger is really one step shorter from danger, if it's just a D, this is just really, really very dangerous thing. Sorry, I see some message on chat. Okay. And whenever I think about anger, it really reminds about burning hot charcoal, which we are carrying in our hand. So if we are having any anger in our mind, it's like really carrying very, very hot burning charcoal and just really waiting to throw on someone whom I feel that I'm really angry with. Yeah. So that's the kind of situation. And everybody might have heard this name, Ramanuja. Yeah. Ramanuja is Ram plus Anuj, younger brother of Ram. Similarly, anger is also known by another name called Kamanuja, which is younger brother of Kam, that's lust. Yeah. So whenever we have so much desires and those desires are not getting fulfilled, we start getting anger. Why this is happening? Why I'm not really getting all this, what I'm really qualified for? So it's mentioned in Bhagavad Gita also, 3.37, that anger comes from a mode of passion. And also it's mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, I will just share this, 2.63. Yeah. We can see here. When we are really angry, what happens? So from anger, complete delusion arises, and from delusion, bewilderment of memory. And when memory is bewildered, intelligence is lost. And when intelligence is lost, one falls down again into the material pool. So that's what happens whenever we are angry. We don't remember that moment, what exactly is our state of mind. And we just behave, which we should not. Yeah. So also, Krishna has mentioned that there are three gates leading to hell: lust, anger, and greed. And as I said, if lust is not controlled, that leads to a wrath, that's anger, which is 3.37. So that's the kind of situation we are really having. Yeah, that we know that yes, anger is very, very bad, and but what is the source of anger? Because everything, whatever we have, we say Krishna is the source of everything. So do we feel like Krishna is the source of anger? Anybody feels in this group, Krishna is the source of anger if everything is coming from them? Okay. See, even Krishna, like Lord also shown his anger in his pastime. So with Krishna, I would really appreciate if devotees can unmute themselves or would like to participate in chat, would like to make this more interactive session. So Krishna, if you remember in the Dwapar Yuga, yeah, he also shown his anger. Anybody remembers like when Krishna shown his anger and to whom? Yes, Mataji. Thank you. Yes, it's Bhishma. Yes, there are a few other pastimes also, but you're right. Lord Ram also shown his anger. Anybody remembers when Lord Ram shown his anger? In his pastime, Lord Ram, devotee feels he did not, looks like. Yes, Namrata Mataji. Yes, he shown that to ocean when he was not allowing him to cross, when he was trying to cross to Lanka. Yeah. So, yes, he was very angry on that moment. Our Lord Gauranga also was very angry in one particular incident, one particular pastime. I'm sure, yes, Sridevi Mataji, yes, when Sita Mata was kidnapped, then also Lord Ram was. But that time he was not really showing his anger. He was showing more kind of a mood of like, why this is happening. Yeah. Yes, Namrata Mataji, that Lord Gauranga, when Jagai and Madai, that happened. Yes, when Nityanand Prabhu was injured by Jagai Madai, Lord was really about to kill Jagai, yeah, from his Sudarshan Chakra. So yes, Lord has also shown his anger. In Ramayana also, if we see, there are three types of anger. Yeah, short-tempered, controlled anger, and spiritual anger. Any devotee, any example for short-tempered? In Ramayana, who was the example for short-tempered?
Lakshman, Prabhuji.
Yes, yes, Prabhuji. Yes, thank you. Yes, he was always like in that mood, in that particular pastime. And controlled anger? Yes, Indrajit also, Tamateji, yes. In demonic side, actually, everybody was short-tempered. But yeah, Indrajit was definitely, yes. Controlled anger? Who was having controlled anger? In Ramayana pastime. Namrata Mataji, absolutely right. Bharat? Yes, that's definitely one example. Bharat really tried to control his anger. In spite of, he did not do anything wrong when he was entering and Lord Ram was given exile, yeah, because of his order of mother. He controlled his anger and he just tried to tell it to mother also, like, I can do something really, really bad this time, but I'm trying to control. And he tried to control it throughout his life, yeah. Hanuman actually is more example of spiritual anger because he was always in the serving mode. Yeah, his anger was not at all like controlled or short-tempered. Even in Lanka also, he was knowing where to ignite the fire. He made sure that Sita Mata and Vivishan, yeah, home is not burnt when he burnt the whole Lanka, yeah. And whole pastime of Hanumanji, if we see, it's completely, completely in the serving mode, like completely spiritual anger, yeah. Yeah, that's there. We have seen wrong examples of anger in our pastimes in Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is full of many examples where devotee sometimes shown their anger at the wrong moment. Any examples? Anybody remembers? Any pastime? Yes, yes, Sridevi Mataji, thank you. Durvashamuni and this pastime, yeah. This was really, really Amarish Maharaj, especially Amarish Maharaj and Durvashamuni. Any other? Anger being used in the wrong way. Yes, 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 that's correct. Yes, thank you, Mataji. Yes, Shingi also cursed Parikshit Maharaj, that's true. Yeah, so these are the all examples where anger was really being used in a wrong way. Yeah, even it's not in Bhagavatam, but for Kumara, yeah, when they became angry on Jagai Madai, they were also shown, they were also kind of given, given some kind of not I would say curse, but they had to stay in Shantras, yeah, because of all that pastime. They could not control their anger. And of course, that was particularly Lord Leela. It was not, we can't see that particular pastime as a material pastime. So yeah, that's kind of anger. And it's, thing is that somebody can say that, can they really control their anger? Can we stop anger? Anybody has any view? Like, can we really stop anger completely? If we are really angry, can we stop it? Yes, Mataji, yeah. Most of the time we can manage it, but we can't really control it. Yeah. So whenever we are having anger, how to really manage in that moment? And various techniques really helps. And it's okay to be angry, provided it's in the right situation, it's for the right purpose, and for the right person, right time, and most important thing, right proportion. Yeah. Problems we are facing is of disproportionate anger. We don't know how to really control. Even Indradev and Govardhan pastime. Yeah, Indradev was in a very different mood when he tried to went to extreme where he tried to kill Brajbasi, and that was really, really disproportionate anger from Lord Indra. So there are many such examples, but point is, for us in this material life, it's very important that we remember that anger can be used positively, but need to know how to manage it. Yeah, like if we are using our mobile phones, so first we learn how to use it, how to manage the phone or any device. Yeah. So anger can be used as a tools, but not as an outcome of frustration or bewilderment or in that kind of mode of passion or mode of ignorance. Yeah. So we will discuss a few things like why do we get really angry? Yeah. But okay, so let me share my screen. Can you see my screen? Can anybody, any devotee, please confirm?
Yes, Prabhuji, we can. Yes.
Okay. So, why do we get angry? Unfulfilled, unrealistic expectations. Yeah. You all agree? This happens because many times, let's just take one example. We feel nobody should lie to me. Yeah. I can lie, but nobody should lie. And if somebody lies, we feel, why? Like, he or she is not faithful to me. So it's unrealistic. Yeah. Sometimes we feel like, okay, in family, I want really special food. And if that food is not available, just like very simple example I'm thinking of. Or in material life, again, unexpected rise in salary and those kind of things. People feel like I should be treated in office like this. I should get this kind of salary hike. So when those desires or expectations are not fulfilled, we feel a sign of anger. Yeah. Wrong assumptions. This is one examples where like whenever something goes wrong in other people's life, we become judge. And whenever something going, somebody thinking ourselves wrongly, then we become lawyer. Yeah, that happens with most of us. Yeah, we try to do. And assumptions also, like one Mataji narrated this one very good incident where she mentioned that she was traveling in Indian flight, local flight in a plane. And she saw one Prabhuji next to her seat, Prabhuji, Mataji, and their one very young son. So Mataji is sleeping very, like having a complete sound sleep, and the whole 2 to 3 hours journey, Prabhuji is struggling to feed baby, change nappy, doing all the things and managing that. And this devotee Mataji who told this story, she felt this mother, it's so like non-emotional, yeah, not taking care of her child. And when she landed, when this family was collecting the bag, she could not resist herself saying to Prabhuji, like to this person, father, that you are a very good father. Yeah. And this father, to her surprise, mentioned, no, my wife is a better mother. And she was thinking, how humble you are. Like you are doing every single thing and you are still saying that this mother is much better mother. And then he told that actually from last 2 weeks, my child health was not well. He was in hospital and I could not take any time out because I was away because of my office work. And she took complete care of my child in hospital. She could not sleep for many days, many nights. And today, because she got that opportunity, we are going to her parents' home. So she's thinking that, okay, at least she could have some rest. So I allowed her to please take rest. So just see the situation. Situation is same. Wrong assumptions make a wrong perception about any individual. Yeah. That's what happens with us also. Every time, like, we are thinking that somebody has done something and then we take wrong assumptions. And many times because of lack of communications and lack of situations, we make that situation and we become angry. Conditioning. Yeah. If you see a baby, like a baby bear in a zoo, they always give him a small size cage first to walk and to learn. And when they transfer, when that he's growing older, they transfer him into a bigger cage. But that baby bear will still move in that small place because that's the way he is conditioned, yeah, in the whole life. So same thing, like if people are not doing something as per our expectation, because that's the way we are conditioned. If we are conditioned that things should happen like this in our life and somebody in other family has grown in a different lifestyle and they are conditioned in a different way, but our like expectations are not matching and we feel, oh, why this person is not responding in my way? And we start getting angry and that mode of passion, ignorance keeps dominating us. Anybody agree with this?
Yes, Prabhuji, totally agree.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Okay, lack of communication. I think this happens with most of us. Just another example. I have two examples here. One newly married couple. Yeah. So this husband, he used to saying his wife, please give me something, otherwise, you know, and then he will stop there. So his wife, like she was also from very nice family, and she used to follow whatever her husband is saying. But after a few months, she realized why he's always thinking like this. And she just discussed with her friend. And not everybody is in the same platform. And her friend said, why you are accepting that? You should challenge him. And you should, what's going to happen if otherwise I'm not going to do? So she, next time, her husband said, can you please give me hot water? Otherwise, and he was going to take bath in India, like people take, it's not like here in Western country, you have the stored water. Yeah. So she asked like, otherwise, what's going to happen? And he said, no, no problem. Otherwise, I will just take cold water. I will just take shower from cold water. So he was not having anything wrong in his mind. He just used to, from that way of life, that please do this otherwise. Yeah. But this lack of communication can lead to many times wrong perception. And a simple example, if we see that one orange, we have to divide between two children. What we will do? If we have one orange and we have to give it to two children, we will just mostly cut into half and we will say, I have done very impartial job. Yeah, because that's the way we are conditioned in our life and that's the way we think this is the right way to do. But might be possible, one child is looking for pure orange juice and other child is looking for orange pulp because he wants to use that for some crafting or some purpose. Yeah, but that's the way we feel like what's the whatever way we are, like we are thinking, things should happen like that way. So that's all lack of communication. Yeah. Unhealthy comparison. Yes, this happens. We always feel in our family also, in our office also, in our temple also, he's having this, she's having this, but we forget that every soul is unique. Yeah. Many times comparison between Mataji's and Prabhuji's life and all. And we forget that women normally are very process oriented and most of the men are goal oriented. So simple example, if Mataji is going in a shop to buy a sari and she has come back and she is telling that story to her husband, she will try to explain all the process. See, that was the price, I got that discount, he was not agreeing to that. And normally Prabhuji will be interested to know, okay, whether you bought that or not. And she will still, no, actually, like before that, I try to go for this and all like process and detail. So that's kind of, and unless we understand that what is the psychology and what's the way people are going to react, unnecessarily, if understanding is not correct and comparison is not correct, then we will lead to a mode of anger. Yeah. Then again, ego and too much rigidity. It's like either it should happen like my way or highway. Yeah, that's kind of way. Like we don't accept other people's opinion. But even Krishna accepted in Ashwatthama episode when he killed all the five sons of Pandava. So Yudhishthira Maharaj said like he's Brahman, just leave him. Yeah, don't kill. But other devotee and other Pandava opinion was that let's kill him. And Krishna still said, let's take everybody's opinion. And he tried to synthesize everybody's opinion. Yeah. And opinion was that kill him, but not physically. So he just took the stone from his forehead. So point is that even Krishna was not too rigid, being Supreme Lord. But we feel like if it's not happening as per my way, why somebody is doing like this? And our ego comes in the on the way. Most of the time this happens. Yeah. Even we know like we have not, like that person has not done too bad, but our ego comes in between to say sorry, because we feel if I say sorry, that person will feel, oh, it's my mistake. And next time he will feel like, okay, just take it for granted. So people ego comes in between, even for small things. Yeah. Too much rigidity in their thought and anger is never dying down. Tendency to enjoy, that's also one important thing. Like this material life, many times devotees are not in this way, but materially people are just trying to enjoy. Yeah, they are saying, people who understand Hindi, they say, maja, maja. Yeah, I need to have maja, like I need to have maja. But they forget that maja leads to saja. Yeah, saja, saja means miserable life. Yeah, so more you are thinking about enjoyment, it's going to lead to more miserable life. Yeah, so even Krishna, like a devotee, understand this very well, that Krishna has written in 5.29, if I'm not wrong, bhoktaram yagya tapsam saruloki maheshwaram. Yeah, so here Krishna has mentioned that I am the ultimate enjoyer. So something goes wrong in our life, we should remember that Krishna is the ultimate enjoyer. We can't have any enjoyment in this life materially. Yeah, of course, spiritually, if we go in that, then very different life. Then again, somebody insulted, somebody cheated, somebody chastised, neglected, and then we feel this is definitely my cause for being angry. Somebody, like I am being so faithful, that person has cheated or somebody has insulted. How come that some person can chastise me? He's junior to me. How come that person can do that? So all our ego, all our like previous karma that comes, yeah, in front of us. Then of course, like control freaks. Yeah. Many people are control freaks. Anybody remembers in past time in Bhagavatam, control freak, somebody who was so angry because he was having so much control freak nature. Okay. See, Hiranyakashipu, yeah, he could control the whole universe, really, except of course Supreme Lord Shiva, Brahma, like all the demigods were in his control. And he felt at one stage that everybody in my control, nobody can do anything to me. Yeah, his own son, 5 years old, Prahlad, that's the only like simple 5 years old son, but he could not control his own son. Yeah, but he was having that control freak nature, that everything is under my control, and that was leading to his lust and anger and everything. Yeah. So same thing happens with us, like people, many times, many rich people, especially I remember in Indian background, because I have grown up there, if any rich person is stuck in traffic jam, see the expression of that person, feel like, why these people? And especially if any police inspector or police person, traffic control police person has stopped him, he feels like a big, big insult. He feels like, I'm controlling thousands of people in my office. This person who is getting just like few thousands salary is trying to control me. And then whole ego, whole control freak nature comes at that moment. Yeah. And person feels like so, so angry at that moment. People forget that even Yamraj, in the case of Ajamil, could not control. And he also gave that example that everything is not in his, means he also having a limited jurisdiction. It's not everything in his control. So, but people in material life, they forget, yeah, that particular point. Sorry. This is another example. Why do we get angry? Yeah. Perfectionist. Yeah. People try to become perfect. I need to do everything like this. And when they don't get that kind of things, that leads to frustration. And that frustration leads to anger. Yes. Sorry, I don't need to say that, but I have seen like many times in this modern age, even boys or girls, when they are looking for their partners, they are looking for perfectionist. And especially looking for these movies and all different kind of surroundings, systems and this media, they feel that person, my partner should be that much, having that quality, this quality, that much, all this background, taking full control, all like when my birthday comes, like, or any, like any special moment comes with hundreds of bouquets and all this and everything. And when that situation, like life in the practical life, it's not there, that leads to again anger. And frustration, depression. non-acceptance of situation. We don't accept many times that situation. Why this situation is happening? Devotee understand, many times they understand that, okay, this is the my karma and this is like happening because of my Lord's plan. But even for devotee also, when we are really stuck with many difficult situation, we don't take, we start getting bewildered and feeling angry in that moment. Then wrong belief, wrong definition of success. Yeah. It's a, why like wrong belief? Because many youngsters, if you see, they are committing suicide because when they are not able to achieve what they are really looking for, they feel like it's like end of their time. Yeah, and they just try to go for suicide. And I just got this from Yale University, where it's saying that those who can't manage their anger, 9% more prone to heart problems. Yeah. So, of course, we all can understand that angry person can't be happy person, as he's suffering, he or she is suffering, not mentally, but physically, spiritually, everywhere, like intellectually, it's like leading to all kind of impact on this body. Yeah. And people say like, you might have seen two kinds of anger. Yeah. People feel like outspoken kind of anger. Yeah. Outburst. They are just so explosive. Like if they are getting angry, they just bring it out and say, if you talk to them, say, I am Prabhuji, very nice, because I don't carry anything in my heart. I just very clean. But that's not a good thing. Yeah. You might be thinking that you are clean. You are like trying to bring everything out, but with whom you are showing this burst of anger, that person might not have taken in the right spirit, and it's going to be maybe very depressing and very upsetting for that person. Yeah. So that explosive anger is not really a good thing. That just I'm bursting out. Even other anger, implosive anger. So people don't show, but inside they are so much full of anger. And in that mood, like one example is like Dhritarashtra. Yeah, you are not showing that anger, but when Bhim came after winning the fight, everybody knows that pastime, he just hugged and Krishna brought that iron idol in front of him rather than actual Bhim, and whole like that iron idol was completely in the pieces. Yeah. So in that implosive anger, that's also not good thing, because that impacts our health. Yeah. It's really, really not good, because it burst out in a very different way at some point of time, either physically or maybe in a very explosive anger at some point of time. Yeah. So that's not really good. Let's discuss how do we really manage this anger. Yeah. Any question, comment, or any suggestion till this point of time before I move to this point? Okay. Thank you, Mataji. So first technique, we'll discuss what 24. I may not cover all today, like because already is 36, but cultivate nature of forget and forgiveness. Yeah, it reminds one story in school of Japan, where they made children to do this exercise of counting how many children don't like each other. And they said like, if you don't like, let's say five children or your five of your classmate, so everybody, they asked to teacher asked to raise the hand. So somebody said like one children, classmate I don't like. Somebody said two, somebody said five, somebody said seven. So teacher said, okay, fine. As many classmates you don't like, next day you bring boiled potato in a plastic bag in the same number. Yeah. So everybody thought, okay, fine. It's a good exercise. They brought those numbers of boiled potato. Now, teacher said, you carry these potato wherever you are going, even in the restroom. So for a few hours, it was a fun for every children. Yeah, it's a fun. After a few hours, they were feeling like, what's this going on? It became a bit burden. After one day, like then teacher said, take it to your home and you have to carry the same thing at your home. And they informed to their parents that they have to do this exercise. Next day, they were asked to bring same like in the school. Then this continued for 5 days. After 5 days, like fifth day, it was really smelling. And children were really, really tired. All children were feeling what's really going on. And teacher said, you can't carry this burden for just 5 days. Remember, many people who are having this anger, you are also having this anger and this impression that I don't like this classmate, I don't like this. For your lifetime, this is going to, this is a burden to your health. Yeah. So point here is that don't carry so much weight and grudging attitude in your mind. Most of us had certain incident in our life where we don't like someone, where we don't like that particular moment. It just like goes like that. Yeah. So it's very important that we develop this nature of forgiveness. Yeah. Because what we are, we will see that person that way. If you see like Maharaj, many Maharaj, they are in a different platform. Somebody is getting angry. Somebody is like bringing something bad. They are trying to avoid because they see in a different level. And simple thing is that if we are pressing orange, we will get orange juice. We will press mango, we will get mango juice. Yeah. If I press orange, I can't get mango juice. Why? Because that's the property of that orange. Same way, if we are full of peacefulness, compassion, that kind of nature, even somebody is igniting, all that compassion will come out, all that humility will come out. But if we are full of all these bad quality, somebody just touch us or trigger something, immediately we will burst out. Yeah. So developing nature of forgiveness is very important. And I remember when Guru Maharaj mentioned that, one Mataji mentioned to him that she was upset with one person for 20 plus years. Yeah. Just imagine how much grudging load she was carrying in her mind. Yeah. So it's like, I always feel one thing in this, that many, like we are upset with somebody, that person might not be knowing we are upset. Person is just smiling, having a peaceful life, but we are upset and every day we are killing ourselves. What's the intelligence in this? Yeah. So try to develop that nature, like person with whom you are upset, like living peaceful life. It does not mean that I want that person to have a miserable life. But point is that why to have that anger at our end, just killing us. Yeah. So try to please build that nature of forgiveness. Change the direction of arrow. Yeah. Why? That happens because whenever some problems we see, whenever we see somebody bringing anger to me, I feel that person is the source of that, my anger. Yeah. And I feel at that moment, I'm fully innocent. Yeah. Now just change that arrow and the direction of arrow and feel if that person is bringing that anger, so upset, or that situation is happening like this, maybe something I have done wrong in my life. I may not be so naive. Yeah. Try to just meditate on that. Because there is always difference in expectations versus actual reality. Yeah. So important to change that direction of arrow. Right association. It's very, very important. Somebody, like if you are associating with somebody who is really good, that's why Nectar of Instruction, it's very clearly mentioned that we should have association with pure devotee and we should not have any association with non-devotee. Why? Because good person will bring best out of us and materialistic people or worst people will bring worst out of us because everybody is having some good quality, some bad quality. And in Dhruva Maharaj pastime, Yeah, that's what happened. His stepmother brought all bad qualities like passion, anger out of him. And his own mother, Suniti, brought out of all good things. Yeah. And in fact, what she did, she made him a good devotee. So right association is very, very important. Then reading scriptures. We all say read the scriptures, but why reading scriptures? Our awareness increase, our perception, our context of thought process changes. Yeah, we start thinking in a broader way. Because when you speak to a good devotee, a devotee will think in a very different way, will not think in a very narrow-minded approach. Yeah. Simple thing, like if we come across a mental person, and mental person is, let's say, even trying to slap us, do we feel really angry or saying something bad to us? Do we get really upset? No. Because you feel, oh, this person is already mentally upset. He's like mentally ill. So why I need to get upset? Just ignore him. Yeah. But same thing happens with a devotee who is actually having a good higher consciousness, higher Krishna consciousness, because he or she feels we all of us are suffering. We all are really ill and sick in this material world. If this person is doing something wrong, why I need to be upset? It's all my karma. Yeah. So that consciousness like changes, and it's like how we see, like that devotee will see, like let's say if we are walking on the road, yeah, and we see all the buildings, we see this building is high, this building is not that high, this building is like this quality or this thing. When we see the same building from the plane, we see all at the same level, at high, like higher altitude, altitude. Yeah, we see everything at the same level. So same thing, higher we go in Krishna consciousness, yeah, we don't see the difference in the individuals. Yeah, lighter we are, if you might have, like most of you might have heard, lighter we are, higher we are. Yeah, so no baggage in our mind, we are lighter. And when we are having lighter attitude, lighter consciousness, and focusing on Krishna, then of course we are going to go higher. We are not going to see all these kind of things. Yeah. So reading scriptures, when we read scriptures, when we read about all good pastimes of saints, our Vaishnava, Acharya, Krishna, all like good Acharya and good people, then we feel like, okay, how much sacrifice they have made in their life. Not that everybody has gone through a very smooth life. Everybody has gone through a very, very difficult situation, but they handle very differently. Yeah. So that develops a very different consciousness. Elevate to goodness. Yeah. Of course, everybody talk about in this ABC, in spiritual life, association, book reading, chanting, yeah, sattvic diet, following four regulative principle. Yeah. So these things really change our consciousness. Feel like in a different way, like our consciousness completely, like, and especially like it related to the previous things also, previous points, when we are really thinking about all this, following four regulative principles, sattvic diet, it really changed the consciousness. I'm sure most of you experienced that. This is very important. Pause for some time and divert your mind. Yeah, when we are really, really upset, very angry, then the best remedy is pause at that moment. Divert your mind. Because if you don't divert your mind, and whatever you will say, it might be possible that speech might be something which you will remember and repent for whole of your life. What I said, why I said, why I did not control. Yeah. So it's a kind of moment of a storm and moment of calm. Because in moment of a storm, we don't have any things in our control. Like Bhagavad Gita verse we read, yeah, that if we are not in, like if we are in a mode of anger, our intelligence is lost. Yeah. And that leads to bewilderment. So that's the kind of things that it's very important technique that we need to control. We need to divert our mind for a few minutes, maybe a few hours, and just remember, like you will also see, you and most of you might have observed that if you don't show your anger at that moment. Next day, after a few hours, you feel that your anger has subsided. Yeah. That intensity of anger has gone down. Yeah. And you feel like, okay, fine. Yeah. An important thing is that it's important that this, even like in our material life, when we like marry somebody, we try to accept, like that's a Vedic culture, especially in Indian cultures and Vedic cultures, it used to happen in previous time, definitely. Person marrying wife, like that Mataji, they accept or he accept that family also, similarly for a girl, yeah, she accept the family of her husband and try to forgive their anger or any like bad things. If for a devotee, we feel like we are trying to go in Krishna family, and this whole world is Krishna family. So we feel that, okay, this is all Krishna family. I have to adopt this whole world. Of course, like it takes time. It's easier said than done. But when we have that thought process in our mind that I have to accept my Krishna, yeah, as my end target, and this whole world is his family. So I need to really ignore all the bad qualities or bad things about individuals. Yeah. So that kind of thought process, that kind of consciousness really change our mind. Yeah. Even people in this time, in this, they start getting upset or getting so angry when they read or when they, listen to the news. Yeah. They say, why this is happening? Why this person is doing like this? Yeah. So, and if we don't control, it becomes our habit. And we feel like next time, if I'm just getting angry, yeah, that's fine. Yeah, because that has become my habit. Yeah, very important to really control ourselves. Yeah, because many factors are really not in our control. Yeah. And that was also somebody I read somewhere that 70% of our mind is occupied by thoughts which are not in our control. Yeah. So 70% of mind is occupied by those thoughts which are not in our control. Yeah. Someone sledging us, and just between sledging and then stimulus, people know like there is a choice. Yeah. So from A to B, there is a choice, there is a C. Yeah. So we have our choice and how to respond and how to not react in that situation. So we need to really behave ourselves as a still water bottle, not like as a fizzy water bottle that you shake that fizzy water bottle and open, it will burst. But still water bottle, you shake, you do whatever, you open, it's always calm. That's like nature of a devotee. Yeah. Avoid triggers and negative spirals. If we know that I'm getting angry with someone, try to avoid that like situation. Try to avoid, like if you're traveling in a car and we know at that particular place there is a speed breaker. First time I may not know and I may just get a little bump out of that, or there is a pothole or something. But next time if I'm going on that road, I know, okay, I have to be careful on this particular patch. Yeah. So same way, we should try to avoid those situations. Don't go in the spiral of bad to worse kind of in your arguments. Many times that happens. Yeah, we go in arguments mode, and then it leads to really, really bad situations and negativity, so much negativity. Yeah. Write it down. When we are really, really upset, bring your anger on the paper. Many people may not control, they have to bring that anger out. So bringing that, it's simple, like one person, one family, one couple, that led to a certain situation that they never also became so upset. Why these people are shouting, always fighting in so loud voice? Luckily, this couple had their guru in their ashram. In fact, like not in ashram, they went to his ashram. And then Guru said, whenever you are upset, rather than saying anything from your mouth, you have to just pass it in the chits, like write it on paper and pass it to each other. For a few days, they started like passing all the things in the paper. After a few days, they felt very boring, because we feel angry or any emotions, seriously, like even crying. Like if you see somebody is crying and somebody occasionally, something really, really not good, and trying to increase that emotions, person start crying in a more heavier way. Yeah. But if there is nobody surrounding, person after a certain moment feel little calm, that okay, fine. Same thing like in this, like when you are not able to show, like people feel angry when they are showing that attitude, like, yeah. And they like when they're writing, they feel like it's not like that interesting. So automatically anger goes down. Yeah. And perception of each other like may change. Yeah. I will maybe stop here. I have like 15 more points. Maybe whenever next time I get opportunity, I will just continue this. But I will like pause for now and we'll see if there are any question, comment, or any pastime or any realization from any devotee which they would like to share, please. I hope it was not that boring. It was some useful thing, some tips.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, thank you so much for the nice class and nice tips you gave, Prabhuji. Like it's a very nice presentation with a lot of things to think about and to think about ourselves, like how, where we can improve, at what areas we should improve, all that. Very practical tips, Prabhuji. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mataji. Any other devotee would like to share? Have you faced any of these, like these kind of situations? What I said, what led to the anger, or any techniques you have used in past? I'm sure most of you might have used. It's not something new which I brought in. It's just like reminder, seriously, like when I go through, it's a continuous reminder for ourselves to go through, to learn through that how to really handle these situations.
Prabhuji, for me, before coming into Krishna consciousness, I used to struggle a lot with this, like if somebody says anything to me or in the family also, between siblings or parents or in-laws, all that. So whenever there used to be some argument or some discussion, I used to feel bad and why they did like this. So I used to churn that days and days, and I used to not talk to them properly. All this was going on before coming to Krishna consciousness, but chanting helped me a lot to improve myself and to see the people in different, and also hearing to a lot of lectures and reading scriptures, Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam in the past times. So that helped me a lot, Prabhuji, to see the around me in different perspective and how to handle them easily now. And most of the time, I'm just became calm now, like not getting agitated too much, but little bit, sometimes I'll get agitated, but not, it will not last for long. Otherwise, previously I used to hold it for days together and I used to suffer a lot with that. Now it's very much changed, Prabhuji. That's change I can see in myself.
Thank you, Mataji. Thank you for sharing. It's good motivation, like really, like when we share like any pastime. So it helps each of us also that yes, we should really continue that particular activity. And I absolutely agree. This chanting, reading really, really helps. But controlling our anger at that moment and various different small techniques also really helps in that moment.
Yeah, I can't say that I fully changed, but even now also I get triggers of anger or this upset mood upsets and everything. But I have a question, Prabhuji. Like I always used to think that we are practicing since so many years and eating sattvic food, trying to be in the mode of goodness, doing practicing of Krishna consciousness. But even then, sometimes it gets very difficult, like we forget everything in that second and react to the situations in different ways. So it's like a difficult thing, and how it happens, even though I see how many days we eat prasadam. But people say, usually devotees say that if you eat prasadam or if you chant, you'll become calm. But it's not an overnight change. It's definitely, it's going to take time.
It takes time, Mataji, because when we start chanting, it does not mean that from day one we become the shuddh, chanting. We reach to that stage. Yeah, it takes time. And many of our anartha comes, Abhi Maharaj and Guru Maharaj also mentioned. Yeah, so it takes time. But thing is that when we are trying to have these techniques as a reminders, because some technique may work for somebody, some may work for some. So everybody can have different way to handle that. It's not that everybody can use exactly all the same techniques, but it all depends on the situation also. But when we are continuously reminding ourselves, that really actually helps. In a longer term, you will see, it's very difficult to say that anybody can reach to a stage where they say, I don't get anger at all. Seriously. It may be at Uttam Adhikari stage also, not sure. I can't even think of, but whether people can say at that stage also. Yeah. But point is that our intensity of anger has changed. Yeah. As you rightly said that earlier you used to have few spikes, now maybe for few days, few maybe weeks, but now that intensity is going down. Yeah. So that's also a big improvement and that's a big success. Yeah, that we know, next time when we are angry, even we realize that, I made a mistake. Yeah, that's also a good sign that I'm realizing that I'm making a mistake. Yeah, this is a wrong thing. And then once we start realizing that I'm making some mistake, I start feeling that I need to take some actions to control it better next time. So I think that's a good sign. One day, absolutely, I'm sure, it will lead all of us to that stage where we can say, yes, it's really, really, I'm slightly away from all this.
Yes, Prabhuji. Yeah. Thank you so much.
I see Namrata Mataji, you have raised your hand. Mataji?
Yes, Hare Krishna. It was a really practical and very nice class. I think I would like to ask you the notes, Prabhuji, because I would like to take this class to my family members also, because a lot of them are facing this issue, including me. But yes, in my case, I can say that after coming to Krishna consciousness, it made a difference, because when you are genuinely looking for a solution will come to you. So, yes, chanting, then reading scriptures, this, and hearing from the devotees. So this has made a lot of difference in me, which I can say, definitely, I had a short-tempered nature previously, and I used to find solution how to overcome this, how to do this. I might get a situational solution, but not the root solution, the root cause. How to eradicate it? Not eradicate it. You cannot totally eradicate it, but how to actually manage it. So, yes, after coming to Krishna consciousness, I have found out many things. Especially now, what I do is, whenever there is a triggering situation, I chant. I go to chanting. So, leaving whatever people is saying around, I just start chanting. So that has really helped me a lot. And another thing I do is now, what I do is if the situation is tense, then I take a pause and I just sleep. I sleep in that time. And when I wake up, the intensity of that anger is controlled. I think you mentioned that also. So from that, I thought I would like to share that. But one thing is that which I want to ask, when there is spontaneous situation, like when there is spontaneous triggering, I mean, sometimes there's a spontaneous thing and you don't really have, if you have a short-tempered nature and then you don't have a time to do those analysis, what to do in such a situation?
Prabhuji, we can't hear you.
Hare Krishna.
Oh, can you hear me, Mataji? Sorry.
Yes. Now we can hear.
Oh, please. Sorry. I don't know what happened.
Please repeat, Prabhuji, what you were saying.
Okay. No. So thank you, Namrata Mataji. I completely agree with you that when we are really, really having this spike of anger and we divert, as you said, that either you chant or you go for sleep, that's a really, really good way, diverting our mind at that moment, because it's really, really not right to react in that moment of anger. Yeah, so that's important thing. Second, you said that spontaneous. Yeah, see, thing is that there is nothing spontaneous anger in a devotee life, because when our consciousness changes, that spontaneous situation is not there. Like, anybody is just getting upset with us. Even we know it's not my fault. Now, there are two ways to handle. Either I show my anger at that moment, show my frustration, try to correct. Second, like as I said, like moment of storm versus moment of calm. Because definitely for sure, we are going to interact with that person again. Yeah. And if that person is angry, and we try to control, like try to give whatever argument or any right reasoning, that person will not understand. So sometimes it's good that if someone is angry with us, don't suppress. Let him or her bring that out. Yeah. Very important, like that's a technique also, that please, the only technique is don't suppress at that time. Yeah. And then once that moment of storm is gone, then in moment of calm, that person and you will also meditate and see that, okay, why that happened? Why that like kind of things? And then you will start thinking in a very different way. So that changed the consciousness. And in my view, like as you said earlier, like all of us really, and even now also, there are a few situations where we react spontaneously. Yeah. But more and more gradually we are developing this Krishna consciousness through various different means. This reaction in terms of a spontaneous way is changing. Yeah. So like we react, rather than reacting, we respond. Yeah. So that's what like start
Hare
happening.
Hare Krishna, I'm sorry, Prabhu. Hare Krishna, Prabhu, I'm not able to hear your voice properly.
We can hear Mataji.
No,
you were audible, Prabhuji. We can hear you.
Okay. I'm sorry. Maybe my network issue. I'm sorry.
No, that's fine, Mataji. I'm sorry that you were not able to hear. Can you hear me, Mataji? Is this better now? I'm just keeping my microphone very close.
Yes.
Okay. So I hope, Mataji, you could hear something, and I think Mataji has dropped now, looks like. You are here,
Mataji. Yeah, I just dropped off, I think, when you were telling that when somebody is angry, don't suppress. I think I dropped off with that.
Yeah. And this, Mataji, like this is really, really a journey for all of us. Yeah. It's very importantly mentioned that burn anger before anger burns you. Yeah. In fact, like not only just burns you, or like it burns your happiness and burns your peace. Yeah. Because if it's not controlled properly, it just burns many times people's life. It's not like reversible also. Very difficult to then control.
Yes, Prabhuji, very, very true, very true. Also, I would be looking for the follow-up lecture, what you are saying. If there is something more, definitely I would like to
understand. Yeah, I could cover 10 tips. I have like 15, 16 more tips, Mataji. I hope something may be more applicable in individual's case. So.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mataji. Thank you very much. Anybody, before we close, any comments, relations, suggestion? Sridevi Mataji, anything from your end? Any guidance, Mataji?
Hare Krishna, Prabhu, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Prabhupada, all glories to our Gurudev. Such an important lecture and so very important for our spiritual life. I would really like to have the PowerPoint slides because this is going to be very helpful for me to help others. So please be so kind as to share it with us. This knowledge is very important because it's practical application of the philosophy. So I can only say thank you, thank you, thank you, and keep going.
Thank you, Mataji. I just seek everybody's blessings only. Seriously.
We seek your blessings. Oh, you and Anand Vrindavan Mataji are successful Grihasthas. So you have to lead life nicely without getting angry and without losing it.
No, no, Mataji. I'm just...
Just
having thank you, Mataji. Thank you, Hare Krishna, Mataji. Okay, you're sure, Mataji. I will share. Anybody has any last comment or anything, any suggestions, any advice, any relation? Please unmute yourself. Because it will help me in my shortcomings.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you very much. This is a really an important topic, you know, for us, particularly, you know, for to speak for myself regarding this anger management. Really, you know, as we are trying to do sadhana and try to get out of this anger, how to address, you know, at different stages of our life, and how to look at them in a perspective of like a Krishna consciousness, so that we can get through of those anger. Issues what we have, Prabhuji. So thank you very much for this topic, and as I said, like, you know, a lot to learn still more about this one, but thank you for addressing this and, you know, at least starting talking about that today. Really appreciate, Prabhuji. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, thank you, Susha. Thank you. So if there is no comment, Lavanya Mataji, maybe we can close this today.
Yes, Prabhuji, sure. I see no questions in Facebook too. So
when we are... Sorry, somebody saying something?
No.
Okay. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Gurudev ki jai, Anant Koti Vaishnava Brand ki jai.
Thank you, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much for your association. Thank you.
Thank you, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.